Hi, I'm Kate Harrison. I work in Dr. Krista Wigginton's lab, and I'm a second-year PhD student here at the University of Michigan. Today, I'm going to give you a tour of the environmental biotechnology lab space. The main thing I want you to get out of this video is answering the question, do I see myself here? So hopefully, after the end of this video, you'll be able to answer that question. So before we walk downstairs and look at the lab space, I want to talk a little bit about environmental biotechnology. So we have four PIs, principal investigators, in our group: Glenn Diger, Nancy Love, Luke Raskin, and Krista Wigginton. And because we have these four PIs in our lab space, it makes it really nice to collaborate, work together, and get a lot of expertise in our lab space. It's one of the reasons that I really liked coming here is because we have many different graduate students that all have different expertise. So follow me downstairs and I'll show you the lab space. We'll start in the general lab first. Okay, so here we are in the basement of EWRE and I'm about to go into the general lab space. One of the things we've been trying to do for COVID restrictions is just to label our name before we go in and out of rooms. This is just one of the things that we've adapted to for trying to prevent the spread of COVID-19 in our lab space. So now follow me into the lab. So one of the machines that we have in the main lab is our ultracentrifuge. We also have some other different centrifuges that are all available to use. The Wigginton group really uses this for sucrose gradients and a variety of other things, so it's really helpful to have this machine in our lab. So the general lab is also where we store a lot of our chemicals, and so we share most of our organic chemicals, inorganic chemicals, flammable chemicals. All of those things are housed in this lab. We also have some specific areas where we put chemicals for specific uses. Okay, so in the back of the main lab is where we have something called our nuclease-free zone. So this is where a lot of DNA and RNA extractions take place. We try to keep this space nuclease-free so that the extractions are not contaminated. So now we're going to leave the main lab and go into the bioreactor room. And a lot of Luke Raskin students work in here investigating different questions related to bioreactors. So one of the projects in the bioreactor room is focused on partial denitritation NOx in mainstream nitrogen removal in wastewater treatment. And so this is a membrane-aerated bioreactor system, and it reduces the oxygen demand by 60% and reduces the carbon demand by 100% when compared to traditional nitrification and denitrification in wastewater treatment. Okay, so now we're going to leave the bioreactor room, and I'm going to go show you where we analyze our DNA and RNA samples. So now we're in what we call the imaging lab, and one of the things we do in here is qPCR, or quantitative polymerase chain reaction. We also do PCR, or ddPCR, and we actually have a droplet generator. So this is where I make most of my qPCR reactions, and then I put them in the thermocycler to analyze. Another machine that we have in our imaging lab that's open for students to use is our chemagic extractor. This is especially important for a project we're working on right now, looking at nucleic acids in wastewater. And this is really relevant to the COVID-19 pandemic because we're looking at nucleic acids and that signal in wastewater and how to track it for the pandemic. So across the hall is our virus lab. This is actually one of the reasons that got me really excited about University of Michigan, because I had never done any work in BSL2 or biosafety level 2. So we have three BSL2 spaces in our lab space, and this is one of them. Another project that we have in our virus lab is dealing with UV light. So we can turn on the collimated beams in this box, and they produce UV light, and we can look at the effect of UV light on viruses. One of the main things we do to enumerate viruses is count plaque assays. So here I have a petri dish that we've added the bacterial host for the virus and the virus onto the plate. And when the virus infects the host, we can actually see the plaques on the petri dish. And we keep them in these incubators. Next, we'll head over to the other biosafety level 2 lab space, which is on the other side of this space. So now we're in another BSL2 room adjacent to the one I was just in, and this is where we grow a lot of the host cultures for the viruses and culturing in general. So the Raskin group and the Wigginton group use this lab a lot. We also have biosafety cabinets in this room, which is really important for BSL2 work. One of the projects that's going on right now is culturing non-tuberculosis mycobacteria, or NTM, and amoeba in drinking water. And so it's really important that we use biosafety level 2 requirements in this room to make sure we're being safe. So that was some of the rooms in the basement of EWRE, and I want to stress that all of our lab space is shared by all 4 PIs, and that's really important for environmental biotechnology. But we also have some labs up on the 3rd floor, and so now I'm going to take you to the analytical lab, which is on the top floor of EWRE. Okay, so now we're upstairs in the analytical lab, and one of the important things in this lab is the Orbitrap. And that's important because it's a high-resolution mass spec, which makes it really good for using in proteomics or nucleic acids, which is what the Wigginton group uses it for. And you can also look at pharmaceuticals, but it's way more accurate than some of the other mass specs that we have. Some of the main benefits of working in environmental biotech is our shared lab space. And this really helps with learning new techniques and learning new methods, and there's always someone on hand that you can ask for help. Now we're back on the main level between the civil engineering building and the mechanical engineering building that we call the connector. And so I hope this video has given you an opportunity to answer the question, do I see myself here? And I really hope to see you in the fall.